Hello friends, my dear homeopaths, all colleagues, all students and all lovers of homeopathy. Welcome to today's talk. I am making this video to share a very interesting remedy. So let's begin. See, this was a case of a 10-year-old boy who came to me for complaints of this cystic growth under his tongue. This growth was there since 1 month or so. Once or twice this boy, he pinched it, he broke it, but it again reappeared. So he came to us and he was having only this symptom. He was having no other symptom as such. Only complaint was this. So on this basis, I searched repertory and found one rubric, and on that basis I prescribed him that remedy, and that remedy worked wonderfully on him. I'll just show you his after picture. See, you could see all his cystic lesion growth disappeared. One more picture is there. See, you could see it clearly that growth disappeared, and we are continuing with this boy. We are having follow-up of him. Here it has not reappeared again, and that ranula, which is what is called as ranula, that has disappeared completely. It has completely resolved. So what medicine I could have prescribed, friends? Any guesses? Chalo, I'll tell. See, I found out a rubric in repertory. Mouth tumors under the tongue cystic, and remedy was ambragrisia. I prescribed him ambragrisia 30 single dose, and he recovered wonderfully from that. Isn't it wonderful, friends? See what Allen's keynote has to say. Ranula with fetid breath. See, this is from the reference from Allen's keynote. So I thought I should share with you about ambragrisia. We all know that it is a nozode. It's all physical complaints, we know. Prematurely old looking person, worn out person, tendency to take cold easily is there in this remedy. Embarrassment is a key, cannot pass urine and stool in presence of others. Lot of embarrassment is there in this remedy. So I thought we should share, or I should share with you all about ambragrisia, especially from its mental aspects, through the mental rubrics, through the mind rubrics from the repertory. So today we'll learn about ambragrisia. Whatever I have understood, I'll try to share with you all. So let's begin the journey of ambragrisia through the mental rubrics from the repertory. See, what I found out was that in ambragrisia, and also our literature has said, ambragrisia has a lot of bipolarity of symptoms. See, what you'll find, few animal instinct rubric also there are there, and few of the destructive rubrics are also there. See, what I found out interesting was animal love for. This is very interesting, as it is prepared from a well fish. This remedy, you will feel they have a lot of love for animal. They have a lot of caring for animals, for pet animals or any stray animals. They have a lot of love for these animals. See, one more interesting rubric I found out, swimming desire for. They like to swim, and this rubric delirium fantastic. Most of the time we think of ambragrisia in terms of their timidity, their embarrassment, their disgust type of feeling, but in initial phases they are very lively, they can be very playful. Everything seems to be very fantastic to them, everything seems very wonderful to them, right? See, going ahead, what I found was lot of rubrics of timidity were there. Lot of rubrics of timidity, like timidity, cowardiceness, introvertedness. They're introvert kind of person. Don't have that courage. They are timid in nature. Their behavior seems to be like childish behavior. And in children, we found out this rubric, flattering, seducing behavior in children. This is one of the important rubric in Ambra Gracia. So this is one aspect where they are very type of childish, introvert, coward, not expressing themselves. And in children, they have seducing behavior, flattering their parents. Going ahead, see what we found in see what we found another angle. One part we saw they are very timid, they are coward. Another angle, this is bipolarity, friends. They are very angry, they are violent. We found them in rubric like violence, anger, anger violent. See, they can be antisocial, they don't like to mix up with people, they want to stay alone. See, we have found Ambra Gracia also in rubric mental retardation. This could be similar to like our Brighta Cubs. And see what anger alternating with sadness. This is a bipolar state, that one moment they are anger, another moment they are very sad, very morose. See, they are indifference to joy of others and suffering. They don't feel anything for others' joys and also for their sufferings. This is a kind of completely different shade of Ambra Gracia, where they are violent, where they are very angry, when they are antisocial, they are not mixing up with people. They are indifference to joy of others and to suffering of others. This is total opposite state. One state we found that they are very timid, they are very shy, they are very coward. And this state where they are anger is much more, violence is there, indifference is there. We'll move ahead. See, one more, few more interesting rubrics we have, like awkward drops things, awkward haste from. This shows that they are most of like APs. We found it in APs that APs, there is a lot of haste. They want to do things in hurry, or they want to do things very hurriedly. That's why they are very awkward. They drop the things from their hands. Similarly found it in Ambra Gracia. Ambra are more timid. They are more shy, they are lacking confidence, that's why things tend to drop from their hands. See next. See next, what we found out, that what was core of Ambra Gracia was a feeling of embarrassment. There is a lot of feeling of embarrassment. And they cannot feel comfortable in presence of strangers. Any person comes near to them, they feel their complaints tend to aggravate. They are not comfortable with people around, right? That is the main core of Ambra Gracia. Presence of stranger aggravates them. There is a lot of embarrassment. There is a lot of ailment from embarrassment, right? See, next is what are ailments? See, ailments, we said embarrassment is a key of Ambra Gracia. Next, ailments are that as they are very timid, they are very dependent. Ailments from death of loved ones or parents or friends. That is a main ailment in Ambra Gracia. And see, ailments from fortune reversal of. Everything was going very, very smoothly for them. And suddenly, death of parent or very dear friend has occurred, their complaint starts. Ailment from bad news. This tells us that Ambra is a very, very sensitive remedy. This is a very sensitive remedy. They cannot take bad news. They cannot take death of their loved ones. That affects them a lot. See, going ahead. See, in Ambra Gracia, we have a lot of symptoms very similar to that of Staphysagria. See, now we said they are very timid, so one symptom comes very close to that is conversation aggravation. They don't like to converse with anyone, they don't like to talk with anyone, they prefer to be alone, right? Ambra Gracia have a lot of inhibitions. They do not express themselves, they keep things inside, they prohibit themselves. they restrict themselves, right? That is inhibitions. They might have a lot of sexual thoughts. They might have a lot of feelings of going out, meeting people, having sexual relationship with people, but they tend to control themselves, inhibit themselves, put a brake on themselves. This is very similar to that of our strephisagria. In strephisagria, we have this symptom of inhibition. That is, a lot of sexual inhibitions are there in strephisagria. Similarly, in our ambra gracia also, we can have a lot of inhibitions. See, next very interesting symptom I found out, cannot say no. Now, this ambra gracia patient cannot say no to anyone, right? Because of their timidity. Anxiety, company aggravation in. Anyone, any stranger, any person comes, their anxiety increases. See, next set of symptoms are very important, very interesting. This is one side we said they are timid, they are coward. But another shade, which a beautiful shade of ambra gracia, is loquacity foolish. Whenever they will talk very foolishly. See, they are very curious, jumping from one subject to another subject. They will jump from one subject to another. They are very curious to know about the things. And question speaks continually. They will speak in questions. Whenever they will speak in questions. This is what I remember from a movie, a famous movie. There was one character who was typical ambra gracia. That character, he always was speaking, but his speech was very foolish. What he used to do? He used to always speak in questions. Like, there was one dialogue with one another actor. He came to her house and he said, where are the children? So she said, children have gone out. He asked, where they have gone out? She said, they have gone out for a movie. So he said, which movie? She said, Jurassic Park. He said, why Jurassic Park? She said, because child like that Jurassic Park. Right? So he was continually speaking in questions, curious, jumping from one subject to another subject. Then he asked, what are you going to cook? She said, I am going to cook rice. So he said, what rice? Plain rice, biryani, or a pulav? See, this is curious, jumping from one subject to another. Question speaks in continually, and this loquacity sounds very foolish to us. This is very typical of ambra gracia. You can catch this on this basis, that when they speak like a foolish person. They are very curious, jumping from one subject to another subject, and they are speaking in questions only. So this is a very interesting aspect of ambra gracia. See, another important aspect, what we call that animal instinct or that morbid part of animal comes, is they have a hatred feeling. And hatred feeling for whom? Those who have offended him. This is very typical, like that of we can call nitric acid or nux vomica or phosphoric acid or lachesis quality, where they have this feeling of hatred or revenge of persons who have offended him. And in later stages, when we say that they have this typical symptom of disgust about their own body, because they feel their body odors is very offensive. They feel disgust about themselves. This is a syphilitic rubric, that they go into that stage of disgust for their own body, right? And hatred, revengefulness is a character, animal instinct that has come into ambra gracia. And see, in later stages, where they have gone into a lot of embarrassment, a lot of disgust for their own body, body odors, they feel that death should be there, I should die, right? Suicidal disposition, despair from, as they have lost their loved one, fortune has been reversed, nothing is going their way, they have become antisocial, they feel that I should do some suicide, I should commit suicide, because nothing, there is no hope is there. And last is sadness, melancholic depression, and music aggravation. This is symptoms similar to that of our nitramur. So this was a small journey of ambra gracia, from being having two shades, one shade of timid, coward, another shade of being violent, aggressive, and with that typical mindset of loquacity, which is very foolish. We can use ambra gracia more through our mind rubrics. This is my email address. This is my YouTube channel, friends. If you like my video, kindly do share, subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye bye. Take care.